Hello viewers and my students, welcome back to the class. In this class we are going to discuss about that is the structure of human sperm. We know that sperms are haploid, then they are motile structure and with a flagellate also. So human sperms are divided into four parts. First one is head. Head, then neck. Small depression is seen below the head. Small depression we'll see. That is neck, and after that is middle piece. And last one is tail. Here the head is present at the uppermost area, that is here. Hair is also divided into two parts. First one is, that is nucleus, and another is the acrosome. Nucleus and acrosome, and hair is divided into two parts. And below the hair, small depression is seen, that is known as neck. And that is the, after that, middle piece is present, and last the lower part is tail. So this is the head and the nucleus, which is pointed at anteriorly, and a depression at the posterior end of that nucleus. We see the depression at the posterior end of the nucleus. This is the nucleus. And the pointed end, the upper end is pointed, and the lower end is become depressed. So depression area is seen at the posterior end of the nucleus. Then after that, it would see the upper area of the nucleus, the acrosome is present, a cap-like structure which is known as acrosome. We call it acrosome. So it is known as nucleus. And it is known as acrosome. And this is the hair area. We can tell it is, and it is covered by plasma membrane. This is the plasma membrane, and after that we can tell at the posterior end of the nucleus we see there is some small depression area. Small depression, that is known as neck. And it is covered by plasma membrane. Total head, which consists of, that is acrosome and nucleus, and it is covered by a membrane, that is known as plasma membrane. And also depressed at the posterior end of the, this is the posterior end. This is the small depression. It is known as neck. And after that, we'll see the middle piece. It became the depression. Here seen, we can see the depression at the end of the middle piece. After that, we see the tail. A long tail is present. So this is our total is known as structure sperm. Then here we see small centrioles. We see the posterior end of the nucleus. One centriole is present, another centriole is present at the neck region. This is the depression area. And this is the two depression area. In between the two depression area, we see two centrioles. First centriole is present at the posterior end of the nucleus, and another centriole is present at the neck region. So two centrioles. That centriole is known as proximal centriole. And it is responsible for, that centriole is responsible for the spindle formation, of a spindle fibers, which is seen in the first zygotic division. That is the spindle formation. It is responsible for the spindle formation. And another centriole which is present in the neck reach here, that is known as distal centriole. We known as distal centriole. Centriole, and it will give rise to axial filaments. It give rise axial filament. Axial filaments. That is, this is the filament structure, and it is responsible for the skeletal structure of the tail, and it support the formation of the tail. It is the framework of the tail. So this is known as axial filaments, and this axial filaments, which is meant for the tail, supporting the tail. The structure of the, it form the structure of the cell, tail. So this is the distal centriole. And another point is that another membrane is there, which is present half of the nucleus, upper half of the nucleus. Another membrane is present. That is outer covering of the nucleus. The half part of the nucleus, upper half part of the nucleus, is covered with by a membrane. That membrane this is the outer membrane, this is a cap like cover, is present upper half of the nucleus and acrosome. That is this membrane, this is the covering, and this cover is known as this cover. This is the outer part of the acrosome and the nucleus. This is known as dahlia. Known as dahlia. And the lower half of the nucleus, and the lower half of the nucleus is covered with covered by a additional membrane. This is the additional membrane. This is covered by additional membrane. This is the half of the nucleus, and neck region, and also middle piece. It covered in those areas. This is the additional membrane, which is covered by half of the lower half of the nucleus, then neck region, then middle piece. So this is the additional membrane. This is also known as manchet. Manchet. This is called manchet. 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 So all these are the position, and after that there is a spiral structure. We have seen the spiral structure at the middle piece. So, and in the middle piece, we see the spiral, mitochondria. The spiral structure of mitochondria we see at the middle piece. And it is it provides energy to the tails, move to the tails. It provides energy to move to the tails. So all these are the structure of a sperm. A small amount of cytoplasm is present at the tail region. So these all are the structure of sperms. And we know that sperm can divide, human sperm can divide into two types. That is androsperms, two types. Androsperms and gynosperm. Gynosperm. The sperm, we know that human sperm is one set of a chromosome is present in human sperm. That is X and Y. You can tell X and Y. So after we would see the meiotic division, that X and Y, it will form first meiosis, that is meiosis one, it will form X chromosome and Y chromosome, the haploid number chromosome. Because meiosis means one mother cell get divided into four daughter cell, and each daughter cell contain haploid number of chromosome, as mother cell. So here also XY, one set of chromosome is there in sperm cell, and this is human sperm, and it is contain X and Y chromosomes. And when it undergo meiosis one, it form X and Y. And when it undergo division of that is meiosis two, when it undergo division of meiosis two, it will form XX and XY. XY, and this XX is known as gynosperm. This is XY, sorry, we can tell like this. XX, X containing chromosomes, this is known as chromatids. We can tell it is chromatids. Chromatids, and when it is chromatids, when undergo spermiogenesis, in the process of spermiogenesis, it will form sperms. That is, it is X containing sperms, X, this is also X containing sperms, and this is the X containing sperms, sorry, it is Y and Y. This XX, X is divided into two parts, that is undergo mitotic division, meiotic division, meiosis, it will form, then we see two daughter cell, as meiosis were two, is just like you would say mitotic division. From haploid chromosome, two haploid chromosome also release. So XX chromosome, these are also haploid, and XX, which is we undergo spermiogenesis, it will form X containing sperms. That X containing sperms is also form X containing sperms. Similarly, here also Y divided into two Y and Y, haploid most chromosomes, haploid chromosome undergo division, meiosis 2, which is mitotic division, just like mitotic division, and it forms the same number of chromosome as mother cell. One mother cell divided into two daughter cell, one mother cell divided into two daughter cell, and each daughter cell contains the same number of chromosome as mother cell. So it is known as mitodivision. So meiosis 2 is mitotic division. So this is the Y chromosome, it undergo spermiogenesis, it form Y containing sperms, containing Y containing sperm, it also contain Y containing sperms, the X containing sperms too, and these are known as gynosperm. This is known as gynosperm, and Y containing sperm, which is known as androsperm. So there is possibility of 50% of chances of androsperm and 50% chances of gynosperm. So this is the sperm. The sperm can divide into two types. Then there is a possibility of 50% possibility of androsperms and 50% possibility of gynosperms. When it undergo fertilization, when fertilization is taking place, one egg cell, this is the egg cell. Always we know that every egg cell containing X chromosome. So it also contains X chromosome, X cell, female gamete. When it combined with the sperm, which containing X chromosome, X containing sperms, when combined with the egg cell, it gives rise the offspring, that is XX. It gives rise the offspring, that is XX, which is called female child. It will produce female child. Similarly, when the egg cell, she always contains X chromosome, and when it combined with sperm, which contain Y chromosome, and the next offspring will form, that is XY. So it is male child, because it contains X and Y chromosome, it contains XX chromosome. So 50% of the chances of male chromosome child and 50% of chances of a female child is always possible. So this is all about the structure of the sperm. Thank you, students.